On your idiots.
Yeah!
It's the On Air Idiots Show. It's happening, right? And you never know what can happen. We got day 26 up
day
in here.
Day 26?
Fellas, I gotta ask you off the jump. How the hell do you live like this with the cameras all the time?
Man.
Because this is like a big production. We're sweating off the lights and everything, man. What's going on?
This is all this right here. This is like, I mean, you get used to it. At first, you don't, but and then once you just, they see your butt boon in the shower one day or somewhere around.
I'm
going
to just be honest with
y'all.
Mike trying to be nice. I'm going to be honest. You got to be a ham to be in this situation. You got to love the cameras. You got to want to be in front of the cameras. You got to want to have it. You know what I'm saying? If you don't want it, it's going to drive you crazy. And probably, you probably ain't going to want it.
Sometimes when you do want it, it still drives you crazy.
All right, man, you'll forget about it at a certain period of time because you'll start doing stuff that you don't really mean to do.
Yeah, that you don't want the world to
I was talking to a, I was talking to a cameraman earlier. Right. And he was like, no, we don't talk to them, they don't talk to us. Yeah. Are they like the enemy or something?
Nah, man, they can't talk to us.
It's just their job, you know what I'm saying? They can't say nothing to us. We really can't say nothing to them. I'll be messing with them, though. I ain't gonna lie. I'll be messing with them. They be like, I can't talk to you.
Like, so? Throwing spitballs at them and everything.
I mean,
say something.
Now, season one is, y'all got another new season coming up. Yes. And now, I mean, it's like, it should be like second nature to have the cameras around you. Man.
Honestly, I don't feel like they're around sometimes, man. Honestly.
Actually, this season is a result. This season will be a result of five dudes that used to care about cameras and really don't get even notice them no more.
So we're going to see some groupies getting smashed out. What's going
on?
What's going on?
None of that. Man, the twin bears not even big enough to be
We got twin bears, man. Ain't nothing popping off in them bears.
Okay.
Somebody
who gets the most chicks out of all you?
I get the cutty, I get the booty, I get the twin.
Yeah. I get the twin. Yeah.
Hey, ladies, that was Mike.
Oh, man. This is crazy just seeing, like, your whole lifestyle and everything develop in front of the cameras, man. Now, to some people, they would look at that like a negative. Other people would look at it as a positive. I mean, there's pros and cons to it.
There are no cons, you know what I'm saying? Honestly.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, what?
Okay, this is
a con.
Hold on,
bro.
Stop.
It is a con.
Okay, I'm Brian.
Wait a minute.
This is Brian speaking.
Brian better get to reality.
Can I talk?
It's a con.
Can I talk? I mean, can I talk?
Talk, brother, but talk right,
look,
the roof.
Man, look, man. All around, this situation is a blessing for all of us. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And honestly,
even the cons.
All right, can I get it? Let the church say amen.
But
honestly, man, I wouldn't want to be anywhere else other than where I'm at right now.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So like, I look at this, even though there's like ups and downs, I'd rather have the downs that I have now than have different downs.
Well, definitely, but that ain't what he asked the question.
You feel what I'm saying?
Well, that's the
problem. No, for me, no.
You just said you got cons.
I got cons.
Let me tell you something.
No.
Tell the pros. You tell them the cons.
Tell the pros.
The pros is that we got fans that get the pros to the situation. The best thing about it is that our fans get to learn us on a level that they don't get to learn a normal artist.
Right,
so they come, they become
on a personal
connected,
level.
On a real personal level. So when our fans see us, they feel connected with us.
Right.
They call us by our first name.
Especially, you know, when you had the whole thing with the choreographer and everything.
You walked out.
Yes, sir.
Man, you walked out.
Look, brother.
And you
was like, yo, man, look. We ain't come this far, man, for this, man. I came from nothing, man. I don't want to go back to nothing.
McDonald's.
I remember that whole thing.
McDonald's.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying.
Look, man, let me tell y'all something.
He was saying what I'm thinking. I'm like, man, I came this far. We going to find this dude,
Let me tell y'all something. If y'all think we couldn't make that last season, please do not. This season, you gonna be in for the surprise of your life. But let me tell you something. We gonna make it.
You know what?
And that's it.
We gonna make it.
Let me tell y'all why we gonna make it.
You gonna think we ain't. You gonna think we ain't. Because if I was watching it, I would think we ain't.
I'm like, oh, man.
But the one thing that keep us all together is this, and I know all four of my brothers gonna back me up, is that we're brothers.
We're happy and we're singing and we're coming. Give me a high five.
All right.
Everybody high fives each other in here, y'all.
Now, not only do you guys have to deal with Diddy, but you have to deal with his wrath on television. Mm-hmm. What is that like?
I mean, I see Diddy. He's the type of the person that you see is Diddy, but we get to see another Diddy. Mm-hmm. We get to see the cool Diddy, the Diddy that's not so mean. So, I mean, even though he's mean on television, you got to understand this is entertainment. So,
right.
You know what I'm saying? It is what it is.
Right.
Man, if I say it once, I say it twice, I say it three times.
He's the boss. Don't cross that line and disrespect him or try to play him like Miss Miss did. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna say her name, but you gotta know when to cross the line, when to shut up sometime, and when to know that's the boss, and you gotta just play your cards right, because he is Diddy.
You gotta have tough skin. Cool,
yeah. Like he'll be like, yo, Playboy, don't forget, I'm still Diddy.
take that.
Because he's worth hundreds of millions.
Yeah.
I mean, Diddy is worth more than some corporations out here, man.
Don't get it twisted. He got money, but he cool, but don't get it twisted. You'll go home like this. He'll fire you like this, like he did to that person.
Me too, man.
They call it all week long. Is they 26 really going to show up? They really going to show up? Yeah,
I'm sorry. We're here right now.
Too, man.
You got homegirl sale?
Yeah, man. Hey, shout out to Peaches, man. That's my homegirl, man.
Peaches.
What's good, girl?
Man, there's a Peaches in every...
I know everywhere.
But she about, he just picked the most common name.
Don't even... I know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about.
I know it. I know be 100 girls.
I know a chick named Peaches,
you said
too.
Them.
My night, Peaches.
One night only.
I'm going to be passing out flyers for my new strip club, Nippleopolis, while I will be featured.
Hey, now, we finna put on a good show, man. We done.
Ladies only.
Ladies only. Yes, sir.
Q, I got a question specifically for you, because you had the whole relationship thing develop.
Yeah.
Now, how difficult is it to maintain that relationship, man?
I mean, me and Dawn, we go through a lot, because first of all, people don't believe in our relationship. They think it's a fake relationship because of the TV show. Mm-hmm. It's hard because not everybody wants us to be together, but you know what I'm saying? We love each other, so we know what it is, and that's all that matters. Shout out to Hot 93.7. Had to put it out there.
Okay.
That's a lot of stress on her because it's on TV.
Yeah, and being on television and having your life.
Do you ever get a second to just call with no cameras around?
Like, not really. Not here. Nah, it is what it is. But when we home, that's when we get time. And even at home, everybody don't understand our relationship. We don't get a lot of time together. So when we're at home, even sometimes our families don't quite understand, because it's just hard sometimes. But it is what it is.
Wow, man, I can't even imagine. I bet you
the relationship still doesn't stop the chicks from approaching.
No. They come to me and they grab my private areas. And the dudes, I just got jumped at Starbucks. A dude grabbed my girl, and I was like, yo, don't touch my girl. And I went in, he followed me, grabbed her again, and I was like, yo, what are you doing? And he punched me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Three guys jumped me in Starbucks. So.
But Q gets it in, y'all.
Yeah.
Wow. Don't get it twisted. Get it you twisted. Run up on Q, trust
Every
me.
Every night I got to fight to prove my love.
Yo, look at him.
What's going on over here? Man. Jenny's getting harassed.
What the hell?
That's some birthday. That's that birthday thing going on.
Oh, my goodness.
He's having plans over here. We're going to... Birthday.
Does she smell like Grey Goose?
No, Jenny smells like fresh Jenny's right
now. Oh my goodness.
Oh jeez, Jenny.
I'm about to throw up.
I'm about to get mad.
Everybody, Jenny's about to get it popping in the studio over here. It's about to
everybody leave at the wrong place.
Because I got it.
Literally have a few drinks, brother. Literally have a few drinks.
Hey, I'm getting you liquored up tonight, mama.
What do you think is the biggest change, and you're like, outside the bank account?
To keep it 100 with y'all, you say the bank account hasn't changed at all. It's just a hustle, and people try to blame Diddy and try to blame all this other stuff for us not making the amount of money that we make. You know what I'm saying? We make money, but it's a hustle. This is a grind and a hustle. So right. I would say the biggest change in the wake call that I got is I didn't know it was such a hustle, and I didn't know that you got to keep grinding in order to make billions and millions and to get that level. So it's just, that's the change that I realized. You know, it changed my life around. I realized reality. I had a reality check. Like, it's not that easy. It's not glitter and glamour. Right. It's not what you see on television.
But imagine if there was no TV show, it'd be even harder.
It'd be even harder.
It'd be even harder.
Exactly.
Right.
And
that's where the blessing comes in.
That's where the blessing comes in.
Yeah.
I mean, everybody wants a TV show.
You just got to deal with the BS of having the cameras around all the time. Because they only been here for a few hours. And I'm already sick of these dudes.
Hold on, man. That's my family, man. Hold on, man.
You can't say that.
The lights and the cameras. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, can't say that.
Yeah, dim it down a little bit.
But, you know, it's crazy. The reason why I say that is because a lot of people think sometimes when you have a deal and you have a certain situation, you set for life.
No,
they feel like, what? Oh, man, they set, man. They got signed.
Let me tell y'all something. As an artist, as a singer, you ain't making no money until you start writing. And on stage, you're gonna make some money. You'll make your money on tour, but you ain't gonna get rich until you start writing, until you start producing.
Which we're doing
number one hits.
And that's when you're gonna see the money coming in. When you know you out here singing everybody records, man.
Fellas, we appreciate it, man. All right. Day 26 is going down at the mansion. Be there, all right?
We out.
Idiots.